sanctuary and should be purified. Let all the people that have come before the worship session, the open heavens, the hymn, the first ministration, the prayer session, that God will be anointing all of them for greater exploits for him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Are you ready to do good business today?
Yeah.
Are you ready to take back what is yours today?
Yeah.
If you are ready, rise to your feet and shout, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Let's start with thanking you for a brand new day. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Blessed be your name. Thank you for another day. Another day in your presence. Another day to break through. Another day to get what I could not get yesterday. Another day to rise higher. Another day to get things right that I did not get right previously. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yesterday is gone. Another day has come. Do something new in my life. Do something new. Yeah. Yesterday is gone. Another day has come.
Yesterday.
Perceived that this man had a need for deliverance. that I have received that somebody will be delivered today. And he was in another country. He now decided to go to the country that man was, because no man had been able to help the man. In the book of Mark chapter 4, 35. Mark 4, 35. He told his disciples, let us go onto the other side. The other side was talking about happened to be where this man was. And the same day, when the evening was come, he said unto them, let us pass over. Where?
Onto
the other side. They wanted to cross the water onto the other side. But you know what? The territorial power that realized that Jesus Christ was coming to help this man, they manifested in form of the storm. When Jesus Christ was sleeping in the ship, trying to go to the other side, there are some power that have been trying to stop help from coming to you. Those power will be expired. Yeah. Then verse 35, verse 37, verse 37. And there arose a great storm of wind, and the wind beat into the ship, so that it was now full. What those power were just trying to do? Jesus Christ that was trying to help him out, let that help not get to him. By the end of the day, Jesus Christ arrested the situation and go to the other side. The help that you need will get to you today. In the book of Mark chapter 5, verse 1, Mark 5, 1, the Bible said that Jesus go to the other side. And they came over onto where? Onto the other side of the sea, into the country of the Galilee, verse 2. Then the man that they have been preventing the help from getting to quickly rushed. And when he was come out of the ship, immediately they had met him out of the tomb, a man with an unclean spirit. Can you open your mouth and pray and say, Father,
Father,
the help that have been prevented from getting to me, this very day, get the help to me in the name of Jesus. Prevented from getting to me. Get the help to me. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Every help that has been prevented from getting to you, this day, as God is the one that has made this day, let this day deliver that help. In the name of Jesus. You can be seated. Evacuating the territorial spirit of power hindering your progress. And you know what? These spirits, they were now speaking to Jesus Christ. Don't cast all out of him, because that is your intention. But don't cast all out of this country, because this is our territory. If you deliver this man, we will repossess another person. And if you don't come early, we will come to him with seven other spirits and will still be afflicting him. There are powers that are territorial in life. Then some lesson that we must learn from this scripture is that Jesus Christ himself had to come. There are some help that only God can deliver. There are some times God will send men to your rescue. Men will assist you. It's God that actually done it. Sometimes he will send angels. We have seen this story many times. But there are some other times he comes by himself. He comes when he has seen that no man has been able to help. They tried, they suggested, they tried doing it, but it did not work. Those are the cases that God comes himself. There is somebody here that they have tried, they have suggested to you, they have done so many things to help people, it has not worked. Today, God is visiting you. In the name of Jesus. In that Mark chapter 5, verse 3, Mark chapter 5, verse 3, they reveal to us that men have even tried to help this guy. He could not be helped. Who had his dwelling among the tomb? And what?
No man.
They tried to help him, but no single man could help him. The same thing happened to the man by the pool of Bethesda in the book of John chapter 5, 6 and 7. John chapter 5, 6 and 7. The Bible said that Jesus saw him, that he had been in that situation for a long time, and was telling Jesus Christ, that I am no man. When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been now a long time in that case, he said unto him, with that remain, they now told Jesus Christ that he had no man. The wicked man answered him, sir, I have no man. If you are here, nobody has been able to help you aright. God is visiting you now in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, Father, directly intervene in my case. And let there be immediate solution today. I'm not talking about tomorrow. Today. 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 I'm activating my faith for today. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I prophesy into your life. In any area that you have not been helped, that no man has been able to help you, let God intervene. Let God come directly into that situation. And let there be divine solution. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. Please be seated. Evacuating territorial power. There are powers that are in charge of territories. There are powers in charge of first account. There are powers in wherever you are right now. There are powers that are in charge of it. I'm not saying godly powers. Satanic power. We call them principality. They call them power. They call them spiritual wickedness. Rulers of darkness. They are there. Some people don't know that they are local government chairmen. In the realm of the spirit, in the satanic world. So the physical one thinks that they are the ones that are ruling. If you are not taking charge, you will see that before you go into any environment, take charge. Those were the powers that were trying to hinder Daniel. In the book of Daniel chapter 10, 12 to 14. Daniel 10, 12 to 14. Daniel had prayed. But the Bible said that the prince of where he was then said he unto me, fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that thou didst set thy heart to understand and to chaste thyself before thy God, thy word were heard, and I am come for thy works. 13. But the prince of where? Of the kingdom of Persia. Withstood me 120 days. For lo, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me, and I remained there with the kings, multiple kings of Persia. If you read this scripture, a natural carnal man will be saying, how can a prince be with only angel? I lack understanding that this kind of prince that they are talking about is not a human being. It's not a natural, it's a force in the realm of the spirit. And they not talk about kings or Persia. This help will not get to this person living in this country. You are in a place and there are forces that are controlling that place. That is why it is very important before you enter into a place, decree to the realm of the spirit that every power that is operating in this place, I command, I bind you in the name of Jesus and I discharge you. Let the Holy Spirit fill the whole place. Anywhere you go to, if I go to any hotel, before I enter any hotel and I'm stepping in into the place, because I don't know the spirit of the people that have entered into there, I don't want to contact any nonsense. I will just say, Father, I decree every spirit that is abandoning here, contrary to yours, let the blood of Jesus flush out and let the Holy Spirit fill this place. I decree open heaven, let me have divine encounter all through my stay here, and I take charge. Don't just enter into, in fact, God was telling the Israelites in Numbers chapter 33, 51 to 53. Number 33, 51. He said, anytime you are going to the land that you want to possess, ensure you drive out the occupants. So if you don't drive them out, they will come and afflict you. Speak unto the children of Israel and say unto them, when ye are passed over Jordan into the land of Canaan, then ye shall drive out all the inhabitants of the land from before you and destroy their picture. and destroy all their molten images and quite pluck down all their high places. And ye shall dispossess the inhabitant of the land and dwell therein, for I have given you what?
The
land to possess. If you don't do that, I think best we go to 56 or so. Go to 56. Moreover, it shall come to pass that I shall do unto you as I thought to do unto them. I think, okay, continue. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, no, is that the end? Okay. Okay, go to 55. 55. But if you will not, okay, this way I'm going to. He said that before you enter the land that you are going to possess, ensure you, that's why before you start living in a place, before you rent a place and be parking, anything you, before you start in another office, there are power that are operating in that place too. Already, some of those power, they are frustrating the people there. Some of those power, they are causing the people there to, you must stand there, even if you are renting, and you now realize that, no wonder I've been having some issues in this place. From today, every power that is in this house, every power that is in this office, contrary to the that of the living God, I command the power of God to drive them out. And you now ask the Holy Spirit to fill your place, and you are in charge. Anything you do will say, everything will not be working in your favor in that place. But if you will not drive out the inhabitant of the land from before you, then it shall come to pass that those which ye let remain of them shall be pricks in your eyes and thorns in your side, and shall vex you in the land wherein ye dwell. Many people are living in houses that they have not taken time to drive out the powers that are living there. Open your mouth and say, Father, every territorial spirit, every territorial power, wherever I function, wherever I live, let all be flushed out. Flush them out. Flush them out. Flush them out. Flush them out. Every territorial spirit of power functioning where I manifest. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Spirit of power that have been harassing or manifesting wherever you walk, wherever you live, regardless of how long you have been there, today we evacuate them. Let the Spirit of God and the angel of the living God take over and let things in that place start working in your favor. So shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. Evacuating territorial spirit of power, hindering your progress. Some people don't believe something that we say is like fables. It's not though. The Bible said that we wrestle not against flesh and blood. That the particular doctor, anytime he came to the church, he would just sit at the back and be reading newspaper in his church. When pastor will be talking about some power that came, something that said, cannot this thing be? This one, they become cooking stories. There's something happened. One pregnant lady, 8 months pregnant, came to her in hospital. Said, I want to abort. Said, 8 months. It's not possible. There is nothing that is possible. This one is not possible. Assuming it's just a few more. Why you want to kill yourself? The lady now looked at him, said that you think that there are something that are not possible. Maybe God wanted to teach him a lesson. Said, oh, you Africans, I studied in Canada. Even the technology is very much, far more advanced than in Nigeria. But you people will be saying some things that are, they just deceive you. She now told him, do you know that there are houses under the water? Houses under the water. Even in Canada, where I studied, that they have advanced technology, they have not been able to start building houses under the water that river. He did not know who he was talking to. Mami was that girl. And I said, okay, no problem. Say, doctor, can you touch the pregnancy? And that one said, okay, can you lie down? And as he touched it, All of a sudden, something just entered into his hand. He did not get himself. He fell down and he was foaming and was gasping for breath. The lady just walked out of the hospital. They were not expecting the doctor to press the next thing so that the nurse would bring out. But they noticed that 5 minutes, the woman had come and he had not come for the next patient. Then the nurse now came in and I saw him on the ground. They rushed him everywhere. The doctors, they did everything. They called the wife. They had to now take him to the church. They prayed for him and was delivered. From that day, whenever pastor is saying something, he said, beyond this world that we are in, there is another world. That's why the Yoruba, they will tell you, the world is more than one. Are you paying me? Meaning that there, you see that, I'm only saying that, even this world is more than what you think. There are forces that cannot be seen. One pastor came to us last year and was just sharing with me and wanted me to pray along with him. He said that in his house, money will be getting missing. And he was sure it was not the daughter. God was getting the most territorial power. And he told me about the activities of their neighbor. I'm prophesying into your life. Every territorial power that has been harassing your life, wherever you are, that has been making life difficult for you, let the power of God remove them. In Jesus' mighty name, we all pray. They said, Jesus, don't cast, cast us out of him, but don't cast us far from this place, so that they can always be operating. This is our daily. We don't want to go. We want to keep operating in this place. We want to keep operating in this family. And you will see they call them familiar spirit because they are familiar with the situation in that family. Familiar, and they try to repeat negative things. You are discharged from such power today. Don't worry, by 12 noon, we'll have afternoon session. 12 to 1. Even if you are not here, just connect online. We are going to be praying because enough is enough. Enough of devil's nonsense in our life. I prophesy to your life that your uprising has started. Your freedom starts today. No more delay. No more denial. No more frustration. No more barrenness. No more failure. Such shall it be.